Hi folks, and welcome back to my game of Pi Alternative Energy. Last episode, I made zinc plates. Today, I want to reach the first major milestone, simple circuit boards. This requires a rather sophisticated process with a lot of intermediate parts. The most complex being the printed circuit substrate, which is also needed to craft the final building, the chip shooter machine. The copper zinc battery also needs a few steps to make the cellulose. I will start with the printed circuit substrate, because the moondrop loop needs some time to get to full speed. I grab all the sap trees and moondrop I can get, even though it's not enough yet. I plan to bring all the required resources north and branch out afterwards. I set up the loop of moondrop. I use all my knowledge of belt and inserter mechanics. Thank you. The inserter into the botanical nursery will prioritize the near lane so that it doesn't jam. I want to bring iron and copper plates on a shared belt. This should start producing methane once the moondrop belts are saturated. Formaldehyde is the first ingredient for Formica. But Formica also needs raw fiber and treated wood. I try to save belts and thus unnecessary buffers. Now some vacuum. I only need to add ZEB to finally make printed circuit substrate. Oh, and I need to bring creosote. More sap trees and moondrop is always great. Since I'm here, I can also bring the lead plates. Mm-hmm. Who cares about creosote when it's so easy to get distracted? What is missing? Oh yeah, the creosote. I also need to bring some coke. Let's put it on the other lane. Now, the creosote. For now, I just ignore that the tar processing will stop without a sinkhole. The PCB factory also needs copper plates. Now it moves. I need 20 printed circuit substrates for the chip shooter machine. I simply queue all the remaining technologies for the Pi Science Pack 1. I continue with the batteries, which need cellulose. If I ever increase production, I definitely need to redesign this part. I need to bring stones to make saline water. There is always enough space for one more belt. and there is saline water. Now only copper and zinc are missing. I will sideload properly, that's more future-proof. Methane production is running. The electronics factories are expensive, and I need 4 of them. I want to have lead and tin plates on one belt, and coke and glass on another. I believe this makes it easier to produce all the other ingredients. It's probably better to just go around the glass works. now it's time to design the heart of my chip production. I can't make the chip shooter yet, but I can export the building as a blueprint from YAFC. Let's start with capacitors and inductors. They both need ceramic. The vacuum tubes need the graphite. This leaves only one place for the resistors. I want to connect belts from down below. I want the buildings now. Now I only need a few moments to cook a nice bowl of belt spaghetti. I have convenient access to my global steam production. Iron and copper plates are still missing here. tin plates for the capacitors. I will reroute the iron and copper plates. Not enough space. Almost 20. More small parts are appreciated. Everything is here, except more printed circuit substrate. I can increase methane production even more. The first simple circuit boards, that was really simple, took me just below 7 hours. And a few more hours of planning. And a few hundred hours of prior experience. Finally splitters. Let's use them. all the coke needs is a priority input from the destructive distillation columns. Stone mining has another annoying splitter. And the mixed iron plate belt from the iron outpost could benefit. Oh, and I can make overflow valves. Okay, I need to grab more circuits first. Drop 20 more circuits. I am rich and happy. I have overflow valves for creosote, coal gas, tar, aromatics, and probably some more. I'm already out of logs. I need to scale up wood production soon. All the Moondrop greenhouses have full module slots now. Perfect. Recap. I have built simple circuit boards. The first ingredient was the printed circuit substrate with lots of Moondrop and ZEB and things made from wood. For the copper zinc batteries, I also needed some cellulose and saline water. And then I also needed vacuum tubes, air core inductors, ceramic capacitors, high power resistors and solder. I will use those circuits wisely, but not right now. Thanks for watching and see you in the next episode.